A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 29th March, on the front page you have US circulates draft resolution on Azhar in Security Council. So the UN Security Council has now has before it a draft resolution which has been proposed by USA. So the UN panel has now passed a separate resolution on terror financing. So this is regarding again Jaish-e-Mohammed chief Masood Azhar. So at the United Nations, now another step has been taken. So after the 1267 sanctions committee failed to designate him as a terrorist because China put a technical hold on the listing request that not just India, US, UK and France had brought before the committee. So they are the permanent members of the Security Council. So now the listing request will be fourth. That was the fourth such unsuccessful request. So earlier three requests had also failed. Now after this, what we are seeing is this draft resolution coming forth, which is borrowing the words from that same UN Security Council press statement. It condemns in the strongest terms the heinous and cowardly suicide bombings in Jammu and Kashmir, which have resulted in over 40 Indian paramilitary forces dying and dozens wounded on the 14th Feb 2019 Pulwama attack case. So that has been pointed out in this draft resolution proposed by US. And you know, it has also stated that the primary responsibility of member states in countering terrorist acts and reiterating the obligation to prevent and suppress the financing of terrorist act, as well as it calls upon all states to become party of international counterterrorism convention and protocols as soon as possible. You should also know that international counterterrorism convention has been proposed by India, but it has not been adopted yet. So this is there. Then this is PM didn't seek nod for TV address. So this is what the Election Commission has said. A committee of officers have said that they are examining the responses received from Doordarshan and All India Radio on Prime Minister Narendra Modi's address to the nation, because the model code of conduct is in place. So this address to the nation is being investigated into, because Election Commission's approval was not sought. Then this is Supreme Court to hear plea against 10% economic quota. So the 10% economic quota, we know it has been introduced through a constitutional amendment, but then it violates the earlier Supreme Court rulings. It exceeds the 50% quota limit, which has been set by Supreme Court. So now Supreme Court is going to hear this case on 10% economic quota. On page 5, you have 4 ecotourism centers closed in Wayanad. So this is in Wayanad district in Kerala. The entry of tourists to 4 major ecotourism centers here have been closed as per the directive of Kerala High Court. So all ecotourism activities here have been closed. A stay has been put on them because a petition has been filed by Wayanad Prakriti Samrakshan Samiti, which is an environmental organization. So these ecotourism centers actually affect the environment. You can see that is listed out here how they are, these islets which are there are located on Kabani River. Then here you can see then there's a waterfall here, the forest range located here. So all these areas have been closed for tourists now. So petitioner submitted that the government was required to frame a state level ecotourism strategy in tune with the framework prepared by center, but state had failed to form any such strategy and ecotourism centers were running, so they were closed now. So fire risks are there and there is a need to ensure free movement of wildlife during summer. Then on page 6 you have NHRC seeks report from Orisha DGP on missing women girls. So this is National Human Rights Commission which has directed Orisha Director General of Police to furnish detailed information on girls and women who have gone missing from the state. So this has come to the fore now. There have been reports which have come, an RTI source quoting that 3,200 women and girls had gone missing in 2015 alone, while total number of those missing has touched the figure of 11,000 till November 2015. So such missing cases are high in tribal areas and now NHRC is seeking information. On page 7 you have US tracking debris from ASAT's test. So this is regarding Mission Shakti, the anti-satellite missile test which was conducted by India. So now US has reacted to this PM Narendra Modi's statement that India has successfully tested the satellite, and the US State Department says that this India's NC satellite test is part of a strong strategic partnership with India and US has stated that it is also searching for the space debris. So it is important concern for US government, the space debris as such, and they said that they would be looking for space debris now. So tracking, it is tracking over 250 pieces of debris from Mission Shakti. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Power in Space. So this is regarding Mission Shakti. It says it might have had one message for India and another for the world. So what was the message which was being put forth by the mission as such, the anti-satellite test mission is stated. So it has been stated that it was targeting the Indian population, and the Election Commission of India is also looking into the question whether Prime Minister violated the Model Code of Conduct by addressing the nation on this matter, because the Election Commission has stated their permission was not sought for addressing the nation because Model Code of Conduct is in place. And this is dangerous precedent. So this is regarding US recognition of Israel's sovereignty over Golan Heights. So it is called in bad faith because Golan Heights was captured by Israel from Syria, and now US endorses its occupation. The lead article and opposition narrative for 2019. So this is regarding the economic and social issues which are at the foreground. So the challenge before the opposition is that it should bring these to the fore without getting diverted into national security concerns, which are being highlighted by the government presently. So the security and strong nation has been put forth, and such surgical strikes and anti-missile tests are being conducted to spur the nation into believing the government. But then what is to be highlighted is what economic development and what social development has been done, and how the people have been benefited from it on the ground. So that is what opposition should be fighting for. This is the shape of an urban employment guarantee. So this is regarding, you know, an employment guarantee program for the urban population also required. So such a program will not only improve worker income but also have multiplier effects on economy, because when people have income, they will spend, and it will give a spur to the economy too. So we have National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, but what we need now is an Urban Employment Guarantee scheme as such too. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, we have this Parley coverage, which has view counter view form of narrative. So this question today is Modi the best communicator of them all? So this is a comparison of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's strategy with some of his predecessors. First, this is political, you can skip it. On page 10, you have below, NIA court rules lack of evidence in Samjhota case. So this is regarding the special NIA court that acquitted all the accused in the 2007 Samjhota Express blast case. In this, 68 people were killed and nobody has been convicted. So the accused have been set free because of lack of evidence. So the judge has pulled up the investigation agencies on the matter now. Then on international page, there is no important news except this one disaster which has occurred in Bangladesh, Dhaka. A 22-story building was on fire and 19 people died. At least 73 were injured. Then on business page, there is no news on page 13. On page 14, you have new loan pricing scheme may be put off. So RBI is yet to release the final guidelines. So it says the banks will be getting more time to mitigate to the new loan pricing regime, which was scheduled to be implemented from 1st April. So under this new pricing scheme based on external benchmark, which will be applicable for floating rate loans. So this has been extended to individuals and small businesses too. So here you can see the detail of this given. So Central Bank has not given the final guidelines on this. So in December monetary policy review, that was the last such review by former RBI Governor Urjit Patel, Central Bank had said that all new floating rate retail loans such as housing and auto loans and floating rate loans extended by banks to MSEs, micro and small enterprises, they would be linked to an external benchmark. But now the final guidelines have not been issued under the new governor. So this has been postponed. It will not come into effect from April 1. Even RBI has indefinitely postponed the implementation of Ind AS 2, a new accounting policy for banks too. So this is giving relief to banks on both counts. Then below you have data ownership a bone of contention. So this is the issue which figured during DPIIT, that is the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, and the industry representatives. So DPIIT and industry representatives had talks on e-commerce policy, and data ownership became a bone of contention. The issue came up for discussion. So e-commerce, when is happening, when buying selling is happening on online, on e-commerce platforms, then data ownership is a question, that where would the data have to be stored. India insists on it being stored on servers located in India, because India related data should not go outside. So that has become a bone of contention. So this, you know, this has been discussed here. So you should know that data is important, because targeted advertisements and personalized recommendations are the key these days in e-commerce too. So where the data is located and who owns the data is the question. Then on the last page you have, Israel unveils world's longest salt cave. So Israeli researchers say they have discovered the world's longest salt cave near the desert site, where according to Bible, Lot's wife had turned into a pillar of salt. So this is a 10 kilometer long warren of underground passage. It is in Mount Sodom. And below you have, humans can detect the Earth's magnetic field. So scientists have long known that turtles, birds, honeybees, and even bacteria can sense Earth's magnetic field and use them for navigation. But this magnetoreception has hardly been tested in humans, and many studies have been inconclusive. But now a team of researchers from California Institute of Technology, US, and University of Tokyo have shown that humans also unconsciously respond to changes in Earth's magnetic field. So they are still to decode what our brains may be using for this information for, but this is the study undertaken. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com and enroll for the detailed video course, and also you can download the PDFs for current affairs from our website. Thank you.